Welcome to Keith and the Girl. I'm Keith Malley.
I'm Chemda.
Chemda and I both saw Ted Alexandro's show, right? Separate days.
So good.
But we saw him at the Creek in the Cave, and it is so good because I'm doing my April 15th show coming up, and he gave me a lot of great jokes. I noticed he wasn't recording. This is perfect. No, I think he's great, and I need to see good stand-up to get jazzed. And I would watch some of these so-called specials, and I wasn't digging it. I mean, the good news was it's not that hard. You see some of these shows, right?
See, but I think when I see stand-up shows that are rougher, you know, I'm like, ooh, maybe everybody can't do this,
right.
You know? But when I see flawless stuff, I'm just like, they're just talking. You know,
it's
kind of like an asshole way to think, but it's inspiring when it's good because it feels so effortless and it feels so good and you're high off like how good they are and you're like, I need to live my dreams, you know? And that's how he makes you feel.
I saw Ted, and of course Ted is slow and measured, and he gets deep and he gets political, but not
Yeah, he made me upset a couple times.
See?
He's just like, Do you guys remember where you were when you found out that Trump won? And I was like, What? PTSD. And then he like knocks you out with like the punchlines. Like, who knew there was a punchline to that?
Well, my audience did not know about punchlines. They thought it was a lecture because he will say something deep. And there's obviously a punchline. And I'm the loudest laugher. I'm the only one laughing. And I'm almost getting these looks like he's trying to be deep. And I'm like, I can tell. He still wants you to leave laughing. And
ladies and gentlemen, we're not going to stay in this place.
Right.
There's laughter coming.
Right.
But yeah, but I guess like that ruins the cadence of everybody else's thought process, right?
Maybe.
Yeah.
Today's guest has been featured on Broad City and The Outs. He was named one of Comedy Central's comics to watch. His work featured in the Onion News Network, Mashable, College Humor.
He's rolling his eyes as we're reading his credits.
Bowen Yang, how you doing?
Hi, I'm good. How are you guys?
I'm all right, thank you. Before the show, we do a little mic check.
Yes.
And I asked the guests, just to get them talking, what is the last movie they saw in a movie theater? And yours happened to be 50 Shades Gayer.
Yeah.
Right? Darker.
50 Shades, it might as well have been 50 Shades Gayer. Did not have a queer adjacent character in the movie, but just the experience of it felt very homosexual.
You said that every Valentine's Day, and I guess since the first one,
right,
you would have to see a Shades movie.
A Shades movie, yeah. I mean, we didn't do it. I guess it's just a tradition within the franchise, but when the first movie came out, I went with my friend Matt and my friend Anna Dresden, who I believe has been on before.
Yes.
And we were all single, and we saw it in a packed theater. This is the first one, on Valentine's Day when it came out. And
you didn't expect to like it, right?
I didn't know. No, of course not.
Okay.
We went in fully expecting to hate it, and we did.
Okay, great.
But it was a fun experience because we were in a theater that was willing to laugh.
Okay.
Everyone was just guffawing when they weren't supposed to. And then at one point, like right after, what's her face, Dakota Johnson, that actress gets like flogged. Everyone in the theater hears the childlike dulcet voiced sound of just a kid being like, "Daddy, I want to go to the bathroom." And there was just this collective communal gasp of like, "Oh my God, there's a child here.
Put my dick away, honey." Holy shit.
It was insane. And so I feel like everyone left that experience being like, "Wow, a fucking parent brought their kid here." But then,
hey, sometimes you can't find a babysitter on Valentine's
Day. That's what it was.
As a babysitter, you have to charge double on those days.
Right, because Anna brought up that good point. She was like, "Oh, well,
that's not a good point. I'm sorry." Anna's fantastic, but that's not a good point.
Yeah. So we did that again this year, and it wasn't. We went with my friend Joel Kim Booster, who's been on as well too, and it wasn't as fun, but it was still a very worthwhile.
I haven't seen either movie, and that's because I can only guess. How many times can you take off your panties in public?
In public?
You know what I mean?
Yeah. No, I know it. No,
dude,
totally.
Give me your panties again. It's like, oh, all right.
And she, in this movie, in the second one installment, she carries like two metallic, like, ball bearings, I guess, in her vagina for like two scenes in a row. And it's supposed to like be like a very like sexy, steamy thing, but it just was not.
Two balls in a vagina doesn't do it for you?
Doesn't do it for me, no.
Okay. You know,
no,
teach their own.
What do you watch more, gay porn or straight porn?
Take a guess, Keith.
Who knows? People are aware. I wouldn't go to pay $16 to watch a gay movie,
Right. Oh my God.
Well, some Gay people don't have a choice. Everything's a straight thing. It's like you don't say straight wedding, you say gay wedding.
You say gay
right?
wedding.
Like that's where the obnoxious part starts and doesn't end.
It's the qualifier that gets added to everything. Oh, no, definitely gay porn. And I've shamefully paid for like subscriptions within the last year. And I feel like that's not acceptable
anymore. You're supporting
anymore.
The industry.
Right. But I feel like, is it, you know what? Yeah, it's tough. It's tough to be like sex positive and be like, very celebratory about that industry.
Right, because you're supporting it, and it's like, what are you supporting?
What am I supporting?
They keep getting raped.
But it's also right. Like, with straight porn, it's that, and with gay porn, it's like, oh, well, and am I paying into, like, a system that, like, erases Asian men? You know, it's a lot of layers. But no, I mean, it's gay porn. That's the short answer.
You know what? That is tough, because if I were to watch porn, and I don't remember the last time I watched it, but I'm looking for, like, where the woman is more submissive. And now it's like, well, why do I need to be submissive all the time? Who cares? Just shut up and rub your clit. Like,
right.
What is wrong with you? Like, this isn't real. And it's like, do they have a condom on? This is fake.
It's
You're
fake.
Not going to get, like, any diseases by watching this. Calm down.
There's a crew in the room, and they've all...
When there's people going to see the 50 Shades movie,
mm-hmm.
and it's couples mostly, I do want to tell them, do you know about porn? Or or do they think that's when we become animals? But right now, if you're charging me $20, you know, I can watch porn this way. And
right.
It's not too much.
Sure. I mean, I don't intellectualize porn as I watch it either.
Right.
It's only after the fact.
In the shower.
I'm like,
where did
hey.
I go wrong?
And that guy got felched. Like, what was I doing? Like, was I supporting his oppression? Yeah.
To be honest, a movie like 50 Shades would more be my bag for porn. But I know that that movie doesn't get it right. Like, I have a feeling, and I'm just going to get annoyed by it. But a movie like that, who, like, I would want, like, minimal nakedness.
Yeah.
Because what happens in porn is they just zoom in to the dick going into the puss.
Which
and I'm
I
like,
hate.
Oh, my God, this is so much. Like, where... Where during my sex life do I zoom in on what's happening to my vagina?
Don't care.
Thank you.
But like, it's in their shot list. It's like, okay, well, we get like cutting pattern. We got to cut to, okay, them, just like wide of them. And then we cut to like just the whole being, you know.
My goodness.
Destroyed.
I can't.
I don't
it's
like.
It's such a shock. I'm just like, oh, yeah, that's happening. Oh.
Right. Oh, my God. I love that we're talking about this.
Thank you.
Yeah.
You're welcome. Picture you work in one of these theaters.
Mm-hmm.
And you know people are going to be fucking. Right?
In the theater, you think?
You don't think so?
I don't know.
$30, I'm fucking.
Fucking?
Wow.
Like straight up fucking or like lightly jerking off, teasing,
lightly
maybe going
off.
Down a little, getting some stuff wet, but not like, you know.
Right. But Keith, I don't think it is mostly couples seeing this.
Oh,
I feel
really?
Like it's mostly repressed suburban mothers.
Okay.
And in the city, it's like repressed urban mother, you know, it's like it's
whatever
it's,
geographic location.
Right. So I feel like it's just, I mean, yeah, I mean, they're probably just patting themselves down there a bit, but I don't know.
I think everyone's watching it like he is, like, let's go see this movie that we'll be able to talk through, that we'll be able to have, like, you know, our lunch through, that, you right. know what I mean? That we'll be able to, like, giggle at, laugh at the screen.
You think it's the female version of Jackass?
Oh.
that's actually a really
that's funny
good equation.
Speaking of gay, I have a Salvation Army next to my house.
Yes, okay,
very gay. And but I like going in there, and I go to their game section right away.
Uh-huh.
And assuming it doesn't have bed bugs,
right.
you get Clue for a dollar, Monopoly for two. Great, it's a great. Deal. So I went past where they have their book section, and I'm thinking, you know, I want to read more.
Yeah,
and by more I mean do it. I hear people do this and they seem to like it, uh-huh. right?
Now's the time to pick up books.
Right. So I'm going to look at books. And I just came across The Bell Jar.
Oh, that's a rough one. that's
it was
sad.
That, I also got Guinness Book of World Records.
Okay.
To cheer
him up. Bouncing out with the frivolity of Guinness.
So yeah. I don't know what The Bell Jar is about. I love jars.
You like bells?
Bells are okay.
Right.
Bells are fun.
I like bells as well. See?
Thank you, Hemda. Bells are fun. How far are you in it?
I'm not far at all. I learned that somebody named Sylvia Plath is in this.
Yep. And that's starring Sylvia Plath.
Right. But I open it up and I see chapter one. It was a queer, sultry summer. I'm like, I didn't know this got so sexual right away.
I think that opening just goes on to describe how hot the city was.
Oh, okay.
So it's about a girl who moves into the city and starts a publishing job, I think, but she doesn't like it. Mm. Or it's a magazine job. She doesn't like it. And then she gets suicidal. It's a sad book.
Okay.
Sylvia Plath. You know, do you know anything about Sylvia Plath?
She's dead.
She's dead. She stuck her head in an oven.
That's hard to do.
It's hard to do. And it's, she like basically like hot boxed her kitchen, like put towels down under the door just to like not let any air in.
Now that book I'd read.
I mean, she has poetry that's just dark as hell. She wrote about, she has one called Daddy, where she equates her lover, her father, and Hitler all in one poem. It's a lot.
Anyway, I ended up seeing the movie The Belko Experiment.
What's that? I'm not familiar.
They lock everybody in this out-of-the-way office in Colombia, but American workers. And I don't know why it has to be Colombia. They don't have laws? I don't know. But anyway, they lock everybody in, and then the announcement says you all have to kill each other.
Oh, my God.
But
you don't want to watch Star Trek. I just watched an episode like this last night. Continue. No worries. Third season, no big deal towards the end, whatever. Okay, go.
Well, they do kill each other. But what bothered me is they didn't use, they were in an office. So use office stuff to kill people. They find guns and they all use guns.
Oh.
They use a tape dispenser once. But I mean, use a staple the eyes.
Oh,
you know?
My gosh.
It's just like the Hunger Games sponsored by Staples.
Right. Like, but they didn't take advantage of choke somebody with blinds. Bash a head into a computer. You're in an office. What's the point? Give someone a swirly to death.
That's more of a release for like the average American office worker to watch people kill each other with office supplies. That I would watch. Mm.
But I think Keith is onto something there.
But they just went with guns. I don't know. No. I was unpleased.
This is the first time Keith is very upset that guns were in a movie of killing people.
Yes. Because in the poster, they show a guy holding up a tape dispenser, a big, thick one. Mm. And you're like, oh, people kill each other in crazy ways. That was the only crazy way.
Honestly, without knowing much about the movie, it sounds like you're right.
Right.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I don't want to see it.
Right. Oh, yeah.
Show me someone bludgeoning
an elevator. There's so many elevators. Nobody got their head bashed in over and over.
Or just get their head bashed with like a printer toner cartridge.
Yes. Somebody sees the receipt of how much this ink is and they have a heart attack. There's many things you can do that's clever.
Oh my God. How about change the toner? Or die.
Change the toner.
You're gonna
die. You're gonna die. Yeah. That's the tagline, but we can still figure out what the title is by the end of this.
You have 1 minute to stop the paper jam, or 20 people die.
That sounds great.
There's too many cooks. Get out of here. Let me just take it slow. Speed it up. If I jam it, our heads explode.
Wow.
Hit the okay button.
Right.
But we're not okay yet.
We're not okay. No one's okay.
Johnny thinks he's okay. Two of you will die. Bowen tweeted out a reminder that Andrew Breitbart cyberbullied me in 2009 and I jerk it to his bloated corpse 10 times a day.
Yeah.
How did he bully you?
So
he's dead now.
He's dead now, so good. And right, as I mentioned, I masturbate to his corpse.
That's a movie I would watch.
You would watch that porn of me masturbating, that solo scene.
That's a shade I would consider.
Thank you, Chemda. So what happened was, this was a summer of 2009, and if you guys don't remember, this was back when death panels were like the big buzzword.
What's a death panel?
So this was
I don't read.
You're gonna read. Okay, so back when Obamacare was first being proposed, like the first draft of the bill was, I believe, like there was some sort of like end of life care clause in it that Sarah Palin had misinterpreted to be, everyone's signing up for a death panel for when they die and for this group of people to figure out like how much your death will cost or prolonging your life will cost.
Okay.
So this is just a big point of contention for Republicans. And so basically, blah, 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 Andrew Breitbart was still alive at that point. Breitbart was not as monstrous of a thing. Or, I mean, it was just as monstrous, but not as prevalent.
Illuminated.
Exactly. So I tweeted some zinger at Sarah Palin, or about Sarah Palin. I forget what it was.
Oh, bummer.
Yeah. I tried to go back, but like I think it cut off my...
Along the lines of...
Along the lines of, like, I was like, oh, well, Sarah Palin's a fucking idiot. Like, just nothing, not anything clever.
Zing.
I was 18. And then Andrew Breitbart retweeted me and basically, like dispatched his followers and his cronies to, like, cyberbully me, and like I just got, and I was on a plane.
Did he say anything in the retweet?
I don't think he said anything in the retweet, because back then I don't think you could. But that was, I mean, the purpose of that was just to get people to like tweet at me and like call me all sorts of names. And so yeah, thankfully I was on a flight, so I just had the phone off for most of like the beginnings of it. And as people were like tweeting at me and just like saying these horrible racist things.
So this is one of those things when you land, you realize your phone blew up
exactly,
over a tweet.
Right.
Whoa, comedians that tweet before a flight, balls,
right?
Balls in the vagina.
balls in the vagina, ball
yes.
Bearings.
Yeah.
Well, who's that? Who was that one? You know, sometimes they tweet something and then they go on the plane. They come back to find out they don't have the job because they couldn't apologize.
There was that girl. Yeah. There was that woman who flew to South Africa and tweeted like, "Hope I don't get AIDS."
Oh right. No, I won't because I'm white.
I won't because I'm white. Yeah. Right. And then she got fired, and then the world hated her. But yeah, it was sort of like that. But I was right in that situation. yeah, so that happened. And
it sounds like we would all hire that woman because none of us can remember her name. But
right.
I'm sure she got fucked over a lot anyway.
Totally. Yeah. But yeah, no, that's my little brush with Breitbart.
All right.
And now it's...
What was the... Did any of the comments get to you? Did any of it get to you? Did it last long?
Surprisingly, I mean, they probably did. But at this point, I've blocked them out. I've just... I'm sure if I went to therapy a couple sessions, like it would exhume itself. But no, I don't remember it really affecting me. I remember like just being like, oh well, that sucks that people are calling me this and that, and like.
Did it change the way you tweet?
No.
Okay.
I'm just as incendiary now.
Good
I think,
for you.
Maybe.
Yeah.
I find all the dumb people and I still write them.
Right. Yeah.
I have to make a difference. The other day, speaking of bullies, we were talking about this teacher I had. We had a kid in our class who was destitute, didn't have a door to his house, right? Very, very poor. And of course, gets picked on by kids because of it. And I was telling the story how my mom gave me a bag of popcorn and candy to give to him and how it brightened his day. What I remembered is that my mom wouldn't let me say it was from me. I was supposed to just put it in his desk that opens up like that. But I'm sure
that makes sense.
I'm sure I was clear anyway.
Right.
You know, I at least I happen to sit across from him and I know at least because he's looking around confused. What is this, Christmas? And I'm like, I think you're supposed to have it. I'm sure of it.
Oh.
You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
Me. I'm sure of it. And then the teacher put him on blast.
Oh, no.
Just made a fool out of him. Why? Give me the candy, this kind of thing. So for what? You know, for what? And it really bothered me. And I wish I remembered the teacher's name because
we can use my teacher's name, Miss Ertractor.
Well, I would like
to
know.
Let's just, whatever.
I have a name in that.
But, and I'm just thinking, I wish I did know the name to find out if she's still alive and hurting. You know what I mean? But, and then it hit me, like, most likely more people hurt than don't hurt, right? So that's good.
Sure.
Yeah, okay.
Well, I don't understand why she would shame him. For having...
To be cool.
Oh, my God. Teachers who want to be cool. Give me a break.
It's never been kissed. It's that kind of thing. You have a second chance, and so you're like, all right, this time I'm going to hang out with the jocks.
Oh, you think that's
you know?
What it is?
Yeah.
Yeah. It's the teachers who, like, sit by the edge of their desks.
Yes.
Like and they roll their sleeves up.
Oh, my God,
and they're like,
yes.
I'm one of you guys.
Edge of the desk, kids. Mm-hmm. Look out for edge of the desk teachers.
Yeah.
It's true. If you think you're right, you're right. Unless you're crazy, get that checked out a little bit.
We put up the poll: is your soul regarding the revenge more like Keats, who will go after you until you kill yourself, or Chemda's and Joanna Houseman, where they feel bad when they try to get revenge on a bad person, even if they know they're in the right?
So to be clear, I'm glad, not revenge. I'm glad I spoke up. I'm glad I did the thing that I did because it was in relative response to what was happening to me, but during it, it's not like I'm like, oh my God, I'm so happy somebody wronged me so I can give them a 1-2. Like, I'm never that way.
I will lock them in their own house, get on the announcements and go, you may either cut off your both hands or your penis.
Wow.
I mean, that's why you sleep so well and I need weed.
I mean, it's 50-50 with our audience.
Oh, wow. Like, straight up, like, to the decimal point.
Wow. 50-50.
Interesting.
Oh, believe me, he would say if it was 1 inch.
Yeah, 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 sure.
Wow.
Am I supposed to be the tiebreaker?
Yes, sure.
Wow. I think I'm with Joanna and Chemda. Like, oh. It's not about settling scores. It's just about letting the other person know that you've been wronged in some way.
Yeah, just to be like, okay, here's the line. I'm claiming it because you seem confused about how you can treat me like shit. So just to reiterate, you can't step on me. That's going to hurt, and I'm going to want to hurt you back.
Although, wait, maybe I've just negated myself, because with the Andrew Breitbart stuff, it's like, oh, I'm so happy he's dead.
Right.
You know?
And that's the ultimate.
So I don't know if I can.
A lot of people
push my thumb on the scale.
Conflicted. Okay. Just keep in mind that 50% of the world are soldiers. And let them do their business. Do you know what I mean?
Wow.
Maybe that kid would have felt bad if he hurt the teacher.
Yeah.
But allow me to do what I did, which is glue everything she had to her desk and steal her shoe.
See, but I feel like him being on the fence is what somebody on my side would feel. Like,
yes.
Wait, let me think about that a little more. Hold on a second, because I am really mean sometimes.
Wow. Yeah.
I wipe dog shit on the fence handle. You know what I'm saying?
Keith, I need you to, like, beat up some people for me.
I do it with skill, though.
That's fantastic. You love skill.
Let me mention this. ZipRecruiter, are you hiring? There's a lot of sickos out there and weirdos. So you got to know how to get the best candidates. Posting your job in one place isn't enough to find quality candidates.
How could it be? That's crazy. We live in the internet.
But I posted it and put it on my fridge. Well, that's not going to get it done, is it? If you want to find the perfect hire, you need to post your job on all the top job sites, and now you can with ZipRecruiter.com.
I wonder if people are listening, well, do I want the perfect hire or do I just want to like throw it in the wind?
You can post your job to 200 plus job sites, including social media networks like Facebook and Twitter, all with a single click. Find candidates in any city or industry nationwide. Just post once and watch your qualified candidates roll into ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. No juggling any emails.
I mean, we do it with our social media. It's like, do I have to post on Instagram and Twitter, then Facebook? Mm-hmm. No. You press the button, put this on Twitter, Facebook, everything. Goodbye.
Quickly screen candidates, rate them, and hire the right person fast. Find out today why ZipRecruiter has been used by Fortune 100 companies and thousands of small and medium-sized businesses. And right now, you can post jobs on ZipRecruiter for free by going to ZipRecruiter.com/KATG. That's ZipRecruiter.com/KATG. One more time. Try it for free. Go to ZipRecruiter.com/KATG. All right. Now, let's talk about Chemda the Jailbirds, shall we? First off, Chemda had a fun enough weekend, it seems. She was.
I had an incredible weekend. Yesterday, I went to a Vogue competition. Thank you.
Where?
In Harlem.
Oh, my God.
Guess whose gasp that was?
This gay
Asian man. Was it Bowen's or mine?
Who is so invested in this?
You don't understand. While Voguing was happening, I was like, fix your face. You don't look cool. This is very not cool of you. Because I was like, they dropped on the floor. Death drop. And I was like, ooh, I'm getting all the timing right. Because every time someone death drops, the whole crowd raises their hand and drops at the same time. Oh, my God. The energy in the room. Everything's a competition. Judging, Voguing. Amazing.
Wow.
Thank you.
You don't have to explain. We get it.
No. Yeah, I mean, to get into it would be crazy. Let me tell you, there were onesies, there were outfits, there were tutus, there was best school girl, best business dude, like, just all this wonderful stuff. Okay, so I've been wanting to do that for the longest time.
And all this is illegal and they arrested you.
No. We played poker in the studio here, had like a wonderful turnout. Xerxes, my brother Michael, but a couple comics came this time. Very cool. Let me just make sure I don't miss anybody. Caitlin came, Jessica Watkins, my hubby came, Elsa, and we had a really good time. And I feel like
Elsa Waite started
Elsa
protesting. You guys are
love Elsa. Yeah. She's great.
Well, we had a really good time. We were here, and I was the one who like invited, I think, pretty much all those people. And so I felt really guilty when I won because I was like, come for $20, we can all just hang out. It's not that serious a game. We're going to chit chat. And it's like every time I'm like, I should bet more because my pile is getting bigger and bigger. Jessica Watkins won second place and I forget who won third place. All those places actually had money. So super fun. I was on a high. I went to the train to go home and hubby face forgot his wallet. So he didn't have a Metro card. Mm-hmm. And we don't want to pay for another Metro card because you have to pay an extra dollar because you don't have the actual physical card.
And with all your poker winnings.
And, right.
I know. But it's like that, you know, I'm mad at the system. You know, I'm mad at the MTA constantly.
And PSA, fare hikes went up today. Or fare hikes are in effect today.
Right. Mm-hmm. So they're raising the price every other minute. I walk to work today because, like, half the trains aren't working. I know that I'm going to get, you know, all blah, blah, blah. You've heard me say this before. So we look around. We're like, well, no one's looking. Plus, you know, fuck these guys. I have for the first time in my life, I have a monthly pass. So I can't even, like, do the double swipe, know, which I would have because it was like, let's just go home, whatever.
Sure.
We go, we walk all the way up the steps and we hear, hey. And I'm like, don't look back. Right. Because, you know, but because it's the last stop here, the trains are just sitting there. And I'm like, if I make these cops come up to the train to get me, then they might be even more pissed, right? So I'm like, I don't know when this train is going to move. We go back downstairs. It's like, okay. You know why we called you. And I'm like,
Did I hear you say hey? I know it's been 10 seconds. Yeah. It's hitting me that you said hey.
Mm-hmm. I just want to make sure. Oh, my gosh. Yeah, well, that's good of you.
And they're not even in plain clothes. They're full. So I'm like, they were so hiding because we looked around and there's no, you know, these would have been easy to spot. They're like covered head to toe with NYPD shit.
Yeah.
Okay, so.
Oh, well, I'm sorry that happened.
Well, there's more.
Oh, no.
I ended up spending the night behind bars. And here's what happened. So.
Should I place guesses?
Sure, yeah.
All right. You had attitude.
Anybody else?
You were very, you know, agreeable.
You know what? Sounds like somebody else knows me better than Keith. I was very agreeable.
Okay.
I was a very good person. And
is it odd you have so much money on you and probably weed?
Well, they weren't checking me for anything yet.
Okay.
So what happened was because Hennessy didn't have his whole wallet, he didn't have ID. So they were like, okay, we could arrest you for not having ID. Okay, fine. That's one thing. Yeah. And then they're like, they took my ID and they're like, we're going to look you both up. Is there anything that we should know? And I'm like, fuck, I did get a ticket jumping the turnstile last year.
Uh-huh.
And this time, by the way, I don't think it should count that I jumped the turnstile.
No.
It should count that the turnstile went under you. What the fuck are you talking about?
Well, I paid. Yeah. I think only the person behind should be the one to get the ticket. That's how I feel because I paid.
Lead not into temptation.
No, but I get it because I'm, you know, but they, because I'm what do you call it for the crime?
Jewish.
Well.
It's like a first time, like a repeat offender?
No,
something.
No. Well, you're an accomplice, yes. Right? Because I allowed this to happen. So I get it. But the thing is they say that, like, they would give the ticket. They have given tickets to people who didn't even know each other. Like, a person just snuck behind you, but both will still get the ticket.
Oh, that's stupid.
Yeah, I guess because it's hearsay, like, oh, we don't know each other, blah, blah, blah. You know, whatever. They didn't give that example, but that's what I'm guessing. And plus, they get to give two tickets. So, okay.
Oh, my God.
So they look me up, and I'm like, okay, look, I got this one ticket. But then Hennessy was like, no, I think I paid that. And I was like, I fell behind. I had this tumor thing. Like, feel bad for me.
Do you show your scar, chest scar?
No, it's winter. It's freezing as fuck. I can't take off my scar and my scarf and my coat. But it doesn't matter because they're like, if we see anything. But he's like, no, I think I did pay that, blah, blah, blah. So they look at everything. Everything comes out clear. They're just writing us the ticket now, and we're about to leave. And the walkie-talkie calls it in, take this girl in, and it's me. And and so he's like, okay, no big deal. You have an outstanding summons, which means you have there's something that you didn't deal with. It's not a big deal. We're just going to take you in. It's just the process.
And you I'm can like, try to run for it right now.
Right. Yeah. I think I considered it. No, I don't think so. I'm too much of a pussy. No, I considered running before I was in front of them, of course. But and so they're like, and they go, where are you taking me? And this is Astoria. They're like, Briarwood. Which is so far.
Wow.
And I'm like, why Briarwood? Who cares? What are they going to answer me? So so they're like, it's not a big deal. We just need to take you in. You'll need to process this. You won't be in there for too long. Well, you know, as soon as the paperwork is done, you'll see a judge. They'll let you go. It's fine.
Mm-hmm.
And then they took out the handcuffs. And I'm like, whoa. Like, both of us were like, whoa. Oh, they're like, this is just, you know, no worries. I'm like, wait, but you're handcuffing me. Am I getting arrested? And he's like, no. no. And I'm like, all right, I guess. Like, and I'm being really sweet. Right. They're making note. They're like, thank you guys for being so cooperative. They're like thanking us.
I know you had poker with Elsa, and she told you what to do if this exact thing ever happened.
You know what? I was like, Elsa, you should have listened to Elsa more. What am I supposed to do? So he's like, we're not arresting you. And I'm like, all right, I guess, you know, if you're going to take someone in your cop car, you know, you never know when someone, fine.
Oh, sure.
So I have a picture, and that, you know, he's like, don't worry, but this is like throwing it away. So Hennessy took a picture. So
that doesn't make you nervous.
We're allowed to do that. Plus we're being very obvious. Plus these guys are being very nice.
But
let's
be clear, right?
Yeah.
Officer, I'm allowed to do that.
Mm. Yes. No, I get it. I wish I took video because he actually said I wasn't getting arrested and he's putting on handcuffs. But they let us take the picture. It wasn't an issue. They didn't say anything like put it away. I think we would have if they said it, even though it was our rights. I'm hoping we wouldn't. But in one of the pictures, you see me smiling because at this point, like, the cops are just like, yeah, I know. This is just as crazy as blah, 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 whatever.
They're all chums. Yeah.
So they take me down. Literally four people take me in. It was a regular car.
What?
Two cops in the front, two cops in the back. Their names were Sin and McKenna, who arrested me. Didn't arrest you. Just so I'm with handcuffs in the back, two cops, one on either side, and two cops up front. And I was like, hey, this might seem like an asshole question, and you don't have to answer, of course, and I'm sorry if it is, but why are there four of you taking me in? And they're like, well, it's their vehicle, but you're our person. And so I'm like, yeah. And they're like, well, we can't drive their car, and they can't take our person in. I'm like, so all four of you, all four of them, okay? All
right. Who's catcalling at the subway?
Well, I said, I was like, it sounds like I'm, you know, giving a lot of people a pass up. Like, a lot of people should be thanking me for jumping the turnstile and not getting, because this is miles away from where we are. So they take me in, and the guy's explaining it.
You know
to
what
me.
Would be funny? As soon as they leave with you, if you turn around and everyone's jumping turnstiles,
like
getting behind the ambulance.
You know what? That would be worth it. That would be wonderful.
It would be.
Yeah.
It's so funny that the handcuffs are like the formality, but meanwhile, like on like the technicalities are that you're not being arrested and that they can't drive.
Yeah.
Or whatever that like the reasoning was behind that four person thing. Like it's just. Like the handcuffs carry so much meaning with them.
I know, yeah. And they handle you. As soon as you're in cuff, they like handle your arm. Right. Like, oh my God, Jesus. But this seems normal to me. And I go in and they're like, you're going to go through a series of cells while we process you. You're going to be sitting in this cell, then that cell, then we're going to drive you to this other place, then you're going to be sitting in that cell, then the other cell.
Oh my God.
But it should, you know, this was like, I got cuffed at 1:30. And
in the morning, obviously.
In the morning. And so he's like, yeah, you'll see the judge in like, I don't know, half an hour till we process you. No big deal, probably. And so I go in. Now, while I'm in the first cell, they're processing my information. And I'm looking at these other two cops are processing this other guy. Literally, one of the cops, Mr. Rodriguez, was on his phone. I shit you not. The 2 hours that I was staring directly at him. And his other guy was like on his phone for a while, but then processing something on the phone for 2 hours. That's neither here nor there. Okay, they process me. Come over. We're going to take your fingerprints. I'm like, whoa. I thought I wasn't arrested. No, you're not arrested. But, you know, because of this, we have to put you through the system. No big deal. You'll be fine. Like, blah, blah, blah. Okay, fine. My pinky wouldn't get. It's not. It's not when you get arrested. It's not ink anymore. It's a computer, and computers fuck up.
Yeah.
He moved my finger in ways that I was like, "Hey, my finger doesn't move that way." And he's like, "Just mushing it. Why isn't this working?" It took like 10 to 20 times. Fine, I'm still not arrested. Okay. Sign this thing that says you don't have any cash on you. Oh, because here's the thing: before Hennessy and I separated, they were like, "What you want to do is give him anything that you can, because if we take you in with your phone on you, we won't give it back to you at the end of your process. Yeah. You will have to come back the next day to get it."
What?
Yeah. And they're like, and by the way, if you have any drugs, and you don't have any drugs on you, right? They were basically like, just pass the drugs now so we don't have to fill out more paperwork. And I'm like, okay, whatever.
And just sign this real quick. It says you're Central Park 6.
Oh, God.
Yeah, yeah. So they're like, sign this to say that you don't have any money on you. And I'm like, okay, that's what it says. It says I don't have any money. I'll sign it. I signed it. Okay, come get your mugshot. Wait, what? I thought I wasn't being arrested. Yeah, but you know, the process and blah, blah, blah. I'm like, am I being arrested? Why do you need my mugshot? Just look into this, you know, picture thing. And that's fine, whatever. You're not arrested. And I'm like, I'm not arrested, but you need this? Yeah, it's just, that's the kind of paperwork we need right now. Like, what are you going to do? And then they're like, okay, we're going to take you to the courthouse now. And you're going to stay there. Judge should see you at like, not that long because it's such a like little crime, no big deal. So they drive me the long way. I know Queens. And so I get put into another jail cell. Now, all these times I'm in a cell by myself, which is really good because, I don't know, it just kind of helps you like.
No one likes roommates.
Well, yeah. It's already New York and overcrowded, but it gives me a chance to not be more worried about like how other people are going to respond to me and things like that.
Yeah.
So once we move into something, again, I'm in the cell by myself. This time it's one of the cells with the bathroom, the half wall where you could see like most of the person except for maybe their crotch while they pee and shit.
Right, right.
No toilet paper. There's, you know, pee and food all over it.
Where's Hennessy at this time?
No, he can't. He just had to go home.
Okay.
Yeah.
So he's just home.
Yeah. Mm. And I thought, I was hoping he wouldn't come because we know where this station is. I was hoping he wouldn't come and just be waiting around, you know, because even if it's going to take 2 hours, that's too long. Okay, so he's back home. So where was I in this thing? You're not arrested.
You're in the courthouse.
You're being processed.
Yeah. So they move me to this other place. I'm in a what looks like a real jail cell for the first time because it doesn't look like holding anymore, but I know it still is. Now another person comes in. And I'm like, oh, no, a second person. Mm-hmm. I don't know how to behave. Like, do we chit-chat? so she comes in, and she's like, fine, and you know, she sits on the other side. I give her a nod. I like purposefully turn around and go like, I see you, or whatever.
Mm-hmm. See, okay. I thought you said you wanted to do high fives to people.
And I don't know what to do. So we're both sitting there, very close quarters, very close. On one, there's only one bench in the thing. It looks like a room for one person. Right. And so I'm like in my head, and I know this is so dorky. I'm like,
you make her give you her coat.
Yeah, right. That's another thing is they don't give you it's always cold, so that sucks too. And so and they made me take off my shoes for one because they're like, either you can unlace your laces or we're taking your shoes. And I'm like, I'm not going to relace my laces at the end of this, take my shoes. So this girl, I'm just like, wait a minute. She sounds like she got arrested and we're in the same place.
Right. For what, by the way?
And I don't know. I can't tell.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
But it sounds like she fully well knows she's arrested and she came back. She just went to the hospital.
She worked at some company called Belko. And long story short,
She's got toner up her ass. Sorry.
So no, please. So I'm just like, wait, this is weird. She got arrested and we're in the same room with no handcuffs on, which means I'm like in a place where you get arrested.
Ugh.
And then, oh my God, it was like a movie to me. I'm like, I'm going to double check the thing I signed. And I take it out and I look at it and I'm like, it does say just, you know, you didn't have money on you when we got you. And then on the top right corner, it says arrest number, blah, 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 blah. Oh my God, I got arrested. And I didn't even figure it out. And they left now because once they dropped me off in this new place, they're not there anymore. And I'm like, what the? Can they just keep telling me that I didn't get arrested? Sure. And I'm like, okay. What else isn't true? Am I about to see the judge or is other stuff about to happen? My fucking heart drops and I'm in a jail cell with another person. So I try to get people's attention. Oh, guess what, guys? They don't have to pretend like they can hear you. Guess what? You're behind bars and they can't hear you, even though literally they're standing closer to me than you guys are. And I'm like, excuse me, I didn't get arrested.
I'm here by mistake. You're going to be, I'm not even going to embarrass you, but just.
Right. Yeah, in front of my, like, my jail cell buddy, right. Like, no, I didn't get arrested. Have you seen my skin color? Oh, not good enough anymore, huh? Chemda Khalili is not the name that you want to get arrested? Okay, no big deal. I got my paperwork in order. I'm a citizen. It's all right. Okay, so they're ignoring me, and everything is, like, setting in. Like, everyone's lying to me all around. Like, both cops separately said I wasn't getting arrested. Both cops separately said to me what's going to happen, and they lied the whole way.
Did they offer you a phone call?
No. So then I realized, oh, my God, Hennessy might be around here. It's been hours. Yeah. I still don't have my phone call. So it dawns on me, oh, yeah, phone call, right? Phone call. So I'm like, excuse me, can I get a phone call? And then my cellmate woke up and she's like, oh yeah, phone call. And I'm like, ah! And so she's like, I need to use the phone. And I'm like, okay, this is a different way of going about it. But I'm like, maybe this is the way. I don't know. She seemed to have been in the system before. She seems to know her way around. I'm like, maybe we're supposed to yell right now. Okay, right, fine. Right. And she's like, and I need water. She asked for water. And I'm like, it does say on the wall, ask for water. She's perfectly within her legal whatever.
Yeah.
And so just she's yelling and people are ignoring. And you feel more and more like a caged animal as this is happening. And then EMS, which their office is right across from us, which that woman was a fucking asshole. You stand in front of her and she's like, have you been to the hospital lately? Yes, I have. For this. For what? For myasthenia. She doesn't know what myasthenia gravis is or whatever. And she's like, are you allergic to anything? I'm like, yes, it's a really long list. It's not going to affect me tonight. But she's like, that's not what I asked you. I asked you if you were allergic to anything. And I was like, well, it's a long list. And it has to do with myasthenia gravis. Now, anybody who knows medicine, a lot of times they know what myasthenia gravis is. They know, like, the stuff that comes along with it because it's dangerous in very particular ways. So I'm like, yeah, I'm really going to, like, work this out with you right now.
Right.
So
I'm allergic to yelling.
Yeah. So I go, I'm not allergic to anything. It's fine.
Oh, my God.
Because what they do is they warn you ahead of time. The cops are like, if you get even close to telling these people that you're sick, we're sending you straight to the hospital. And when you're done with that, you're going to come back here, making it very clear to you that if you think you're getting out of this because you're going to say that you're sick, you can forget it. And they're kind of like hinting at you, don't do that. It will prolong your process. So I'm like, I'm not sick. Nothing's happening. Yeah. Everything's fine. But they took this other girl to the hospital. And so she just came back from the hospital. And so she has a special relationship with this EMS worker who's now coming out of her office right across from us when she hears her yelling. And the EMS person goes, can you shut the fuck up? We're not getting you any fucking water, okay? You can just sit there. And she goes, I don't understand why. I don't know. It's like, you're supposed to get me. And then she goes, this is none of your business anyway, EMT. This is none of your business. Why don't you go back in there and shut the fuck up? I'm not even talking to you. But if I am talking to you, why don't you go get me some water? Oh. And I'm like, Mom, she's right. She's right.
Do you say that? She is right.
You know,
she wingmanned her.
Yeah. I did with my face. I was like, like, well, yeah. Not that she was looking at me. She was standing arguing with this woman. And then she goes, the EMS person goes, you know what? I think you're getting a little too upset. And I think maybe I should tell people that you're too upset to sit in that jail cell. And maybe you need to go to some hospital for your mental issues. So basically, she's threatening her. She's like, if you don't sit. And then she blatantly said it because she's like, what are you saying to me? And she's like, if you don't shut the fuck up, I'm going to send you to the loony bin. And so now you're already like, you want to pace, you want to break the wall, you want to like, you know, and they're just testing you and testing you. And it's just like, you want her to calm down now? Is that what you want? Now she's on the phone call, she's on the water, she's talking to her friends who are in a different part where the phone calls are happening. And now they're talking to each other and she's like, CO, oh, suddenly you can't hear me. And so they're having conversation. Did you use the phone? Yeah, I did. And so her friends are in a different cell, like all this shit.
Did you ever have your rights read to you?
Nope.
And did you ever get your phone call?
No, because I'm not in the right cell. Because she was trying to get us, or herself at least, to go to this other cell where the phone calls happen. And so she starts talking to me, which is really good. Because in my head, I was trying to create an icebreaker, but I really couldn't come up with one. It was very difficult. I was like, I can do this. I talk for a living. There's something that could break the ice here.
Truth and a lie.
So eventually she starts talking to me. In my head, I was like, I should just be honest and go, I know we're not supposed to talk, but if you want to talk, I mean, you know what I mean? Right. And I'm like, no, that's not the way. So she started talking.
Are you looking around for that lawyer that none of the cops like? That comes around 3 in the morning, the night of?
The DA or whatever,
I don't think I was in that section where they come in, you know? But and you're trying to, you look like such a shithead because it's not just bars, it's also a gate. So you can hardly see anything. So you're peering out of the side, just like, what's happening? Something's happening. Like, it's like watching TV. I'm overhearing the TV that some of the workers are listening to, and I'm like, can I mentally watch a show? Anything. Like, I keep going to go for my phone. I'm like, no, I don't have a phone. Well, part of why I wanted to go for my phone is, I'm like, the reason why we don't have our phone is because there's no way that this cell has ever been cleaned. Not in the last month, year, whatever. Like, never. It was never clean. And if I had a phone, I could take a picture of this because it's the nastiest shit in the whole world. Okay. So now I finally get someone's attention because all the cops have to bring people right in front of our cell because the EMS person is right there. And I'm like, listen, I wasn't arrested. And they're like, yeah, because you're in a cell. And I'm like, okay, but I wasn't read my rights. And they're like, whatever. And so so they leave.
They're like, do you want me to read them to you? I don't know what you want.
They're like, okay.
You've seen TV. It's them.
You're behind bars. What are you going to do? So, but then my cellmate was like, you've been arrested. And I was like, but you didn't read me my rights. And she was like, that's nice for you. And she's like, I didn't get my rights read to me. She's like, where are you? I'm like, in a jail cell. And so she's just like, here's what you do. And I'm like, oh boy. She's because I told her it had to do with a turnstile, and she was like, just say you're homeless, they'll believe you. And she starts like prepping me I don't know about all this. I already gave them my address.
Yeah.
Whatever. Eventually we do get moved into the place where you have a phone call. And this place is packed. It's just mattresses on the floor with women sleeping in them. And you have to, like, you know, sort of tightrope it in between them. And all the entire ground was taken, so I went on the bench. And she had a couple of her friends there. She joined them. And there were, like, three other girls that seemed to have gotten arrested together. And another girl that I couldn't tell if she was with one of the groups or not. But a lot of people knew each other and, you know, that kind of thing. So I go straight to the phone because I'm like, let me stop whatever worry is happening. And I look at the phone. I'm like, oh, it doesn't have any instructions. So one of the girls pops her head, super nice. She goes, just dial 1. I go, okay, 1, then the number. And this is what I thought was so cute because I was like, 1 and then 1-808, you know what I mean? Or like 1 is the code out and like blah, blah, blah. Right. So I tried doing it and they're like, 1. And I'm like, oh, millennials. They think 1 is a code. 1 is actually just 1212.
Right.
Like, it's just the number that you used to have to punch in before cell phones.
It's like the international code. Yeah,
it's
just
a number. Right, right. So I try calling Hennessy's phone, and I'm like, well, this isn't working. And they're like, dial 1. I'm like, I've dialed the magic number, but I don't want to get into a fight with anyone. So I'm just like, I don't know, it's not working. They're like, is it not a local number? I'm like, it's 808. They're like, no, that's not local. And I'm like, well, they're local. And so.
Who the fuck are you trying to call? Kanye West? Next, sweetheart, next.
It's just, you know, the Hawaiians must feel justified because they're like, we knew that we weren't part of your country. And so I'm like, well, thank whoever, thank shit that I gave my phone to Hennessy because mine's a local number. Oh. So I called my own phone. And he was just about to leaving my phone in our house so that if I come home and he misses me, I call him. He just was on his way out and heard the phone and came back in. So I said, everything's fine, but not fine, but I'm here and it's fine and it's not fine and everyone's nice, but they're horrible, but everything's fine. Okay. So now I'm in this thing. And it starts feeling like shit because it's never ending and whatever. And these girls are so young and they're just so cute about some of the stuff. I finally was able to start talking to people and I'm just like, how long have you girls been in here? Because they seem like they've been in there for a while. And they're like, 2 days. And I'm like, oh my God, nobody cares about me in here. Nobody cares about anybody. I could be in here forever because what I learned was there is no judge in the middle of the night. The judge is coming at 7:30. Then when you say that to people, they're like, not 7:30. Between 9 and 10, he arrives. That's when he first starts looking at it. Then he picks and chooses who's going first, second, and third. And I'm like, oh, yeah, I could be here forever. Okay, so they also said that they didn't feed them until just now. And before, they took money from them to put in the vending machine to give them food. Now the food's coming around. It's breakfast. It's between 6 and 7 a.m. I got arrested at 1:30. And this is breakfast. The most mushed up bananas that you wouldn't even feed like somebody with no teeth. And cereal cornflakes, milk, and packets of sugar. Packets of sugar that everybody seems to be waiting for. Then they're like, okay, you gave us the cereal. Where's the packets of sugar? I'm like, this is a request. And it throws me off. I'm like, packets of sugar? There must be coffee there. And I'm like, no, calm down. There's no coffee. There's no anything. Just be cool. And so now I've been trying to get people's attention. Nothing's working out. Everybody's trying to get people's attention to try something because they're just being sat there and given nothing. finally a new CEO comes on, and I'm like, this is absurd. I've been here for so long. So I go to the corner of the cell. Everyone's behind me, and I'm quietly talking to this officer. And I'm just like, look, I was never read my rights. He told me two or three times that I'm not being arrested while I was getting my fingerprints and shit like that. And she goes, so? She goes, what I want to know is why you believe everything you hear. And I was like, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, this isn't real, oh my God. And so I'm like, wait, what? And I'm like, because it was an officer. And he's like, well, she goes, yeah, so? And I go, well, he's telling me that I'm not being arrested, so I believe him. She's like, I don't get it. What world do you live in where everyone's telling you the truth? I'm like, what? I'm like, I don't understand how I'm the crazy one here. Yeah, and she goes, first of all, I didn't say you were crazy. Did you hear me use the word crazy? And I was like, wow, this is really necessary. I'm behind bars. Like, you have all the freedom in the world. And so I'm just like, okay, scale back. Not crazy. But isn't it interesting that I'm talking to you, a cop, and you're telling me that it doesn't matter that a cop lied to me? And she's like, so? And she's like, you're arrested. I don't know why you think you're special. You're arrested. You're in jail. You're where all the rest of the people are arrested. Why are you different than anybody else? And I'm like, oh my God. So I'm like, okay, but I'm just letting you know what happened. She goes, well, now you know why all those people were marching out there, don't you? Like, meaning now you know firsthand. Like, I don't remember the way she phrased it.
She was black, and she's bringing up Black Lives Matter.
Yeah, and she's like, well, now you know. And I go, yeah, I already knew that. I was marching with them. And what I wanted to say was, yeah, while we were marching, we were saying, fuck the police. that's you. Right. I'm aware.
She's like, fuck me. Fuck me.
Yeah. And so she goes, yeah. But before, you were marching and you just thought you had an idea. Now you know how those people actually feel. And I go, I'm like, what I want to say is, who do you think has power here?
Right. You're like, I didn't need the lesson.
Yeah, I don't understand what I'm learning right now. That I'm white? Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Don't worry. I know. This is much easier for me than it is for everybody else. But that's not what we're talking about right now.
Do you say, I have a lot to chew on. Go ahead, open the gate.
Yeah. Well, no, what I do is I start breaking down because it starts getting really scary. And also, she started being a real asshole about it because now everyone else starts realizing that I have this woman's attention for quite a long time. I don't know if they can hear what we're talking about so much, but they've been, you know, yelling to get attention for a while. So I know this isn't good. So now same girl starts going, CEO, can I get blah, whatever? What time is it? A lot of times people are just asking what time it is because you just are going nuts.
Right.
And so she's not answering. And I'm like, oh my God, you're being such a dick right now. You know that I'm talking to you. And then if you don't answer her, it's going to be a thing. And I'm the one in here. And so I step to the side and I'm like, and I give her the eyes like, can you please just answer her? It's the time. It's right in front of you. And she won't. I step aside where I'm like not facing either one of them. Like, obviously, I want you guys to work this out right now. Nope. Then she keeps talking to me and I'm like, oh my God, you're going to keep talking to me. Okay. She keeps talking to me and this girl is trying to get her attention again. Excuse me, you can talk to her, but not me. And I'm like, I can't say this out loud, but just fucking answer. Just, I don't want to ask what time it is and then you answer me. I'm going to be very annoyed. Now her friends are perched up. What the fuck is happening? So now, and then the cop walks away. I turn around. Three people are perched up looking at me. And this girl goes, what the fuck do you think that you're doing? That you think that you're so fucking special that you're not arrested? I told you already you are arrested. What special shit do you want? And blah, blah, blah. And they're like, and I'm like, I don't know how to navigate this. I don't know. I don't know how to respond to this. She's right. You know what I mean? And there's nothing we can do about it. And so I'm like, okay. And so I go, right? I know. I go, I don't even know what I was thinking trying to talk to her. I just feel caged up. I feel like I want to fucking tear this wall down. And I know that talking to her won't do anything because they want us to feel this way. They want me to feel this way. And they're just fucking driving us crazy, like walking away from us and shit like that. And I don't fucking understand why she can't just answer you. And so one of her friends goes, right? And I go, right. And then we start fucking talking about that. And she goes, one of her friends was like, yeah, why is she so mad? She just got to work. And I go, I don't fucking know. She just got to work and she didn't even process any of our papers, meaning she didn't even start working and she's already this mad. And I'm like, I know, because there's no other way to respond but to yell. And then when they ignore, so we're having this wonderful conversation. And then we hear the officer that walked away a little bit laughing with her friends. Mm-hmm. And they start going, oh, but you could kiki about everything. Oh, it's so funny over there. It's so funny over there. And I'm like, yeah, she's fine. She's fine. And so everything calmed down and everything. But I'm like, you know how this works. We're just frustrated in here. It's going to take nothing for everybody to fight because we're just frustrated. But she fucking walked away after she did that.
At any time, do you think about saying that you happen to have a talk show?
You know what? I was very upset with myself for saying that I'm a podcaster to the first person because they didn't know what it is. She goes, well, what do? I podcast. But what? And I'm like, there's no other way of saying this.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, but I didn't want to say, I don't know. I guess I didn't want them to look me up, or I don't know what it was. I was just trying to like be the simplest possible. But then thinking about it later, I'm like, why don't I say that I have a platform? Why didn't I say that I'm a talk show host instead of a podcaster? They wouldn't understand podcaster, and maybe like with a microphone in my hand, they might do something different. I don't know, but they finally called my name, and then I felt like shit because I passed all these girls who have been there longer than me. And I was the white girl, and I left. And
what were they?
There was one white girl, and six black girls from, yeah. And so I walk through them, and I just feel like shit. I know that they have
make a hole. That's Chemda.
God, but they have. I know that they have a higher crime, but like, what does that mean? We're all like, I'm a criminal too that day. You know what I mean? So like. What's to look at anybody else differently? You're just arresting people. So you go to another cell, and at that what also happened while I was talking to that cop is because she was so anti-me and so like, oh yeah, because what else she said while she's telling me like why you think you're so special, she's like, you better get some people to come help you. And I'm like, what? I jumped a turnstile. Like, she's like, yeah, that's right. And you need help. You need all the help you can get. You better start making phone calls and get people to meet you at the courtroom. I'm like, What are they going to do in the court? She's like, whatever, just get people to help you. And I'm like, oh my God, do I need to start calling people?
Oh my God.
I'm like, what? Like, okay, what time should they come? She's like, I'm not, whatever. She just walks away. And I'm like, this is turning into such a bigger deal. I'm like, wait, maybe they got me on something that I don't know. I don't know what the fuck is going on. You know what I mean?
Right.
So I get put in this other, and so I start like crying while I'm talking to her. And I'm like, I better fucking get my shit together. I can't be like crying in a jail full of people. So I'm like trying to get my shit together. And I'm just, you know, I'm still facing her and I'm just like, don't keep crying. And she can tell that I'm trying to do that. And she was like, look, what I'm trying to tell you is to wrap your mind around the fact that basically nobody gives a shit. And I'm like, okay, we get it. Let me just, I'm going to work it out myself. Thank you, officer. You know, and I went to the bathroom and like washed my face without anybody hopefully seeing me. And it's just like, come on. So as soon as they took me out of there, they put me into a cell by myself and I just start bawling because it was all that, you know, because I talked to other cops too. And they were like, I go, I never got read my rights. And they were like, so? They're like, that's the movies. Nobody reads you your rights. And I'm like, okay, let's say that's not a thing. Fine.
It always bothered me, though, in television and movies when they present this character that he absolutely, without question, is the bad guy, right? Murderer, rapist. Mm-hmm. But he gets off because five sentences weren't told to him. It's like, well, you can lie during this part. It doesn't make you on his level.
Yeah.
Say you read him.
Update those cop shows because that's not exactly how it happens anymore, did. And so, you know, now I'm crying in this jail cell, and this is the one where there's another piece of the jail cell that you can talk to your lawyer, and that part smells like straight up urine.
Oh.
Like, so I know when the lawyer comes in there, I'm gonna have to sit in the urine cell.
Right.
And so I'm bawling. I'm talking to cops. They don't give a shit. They're like, why do you think this is the movies? Well, and I'm like, no, he told me he wasn't gonna get, I'm not getting arrested. And they're like, I guess tell that to the court when you go there. And I'm like, yeah, okay, you guys all very much seem concerned.
Right. Wasn't there something about professionalism, courtesy, and respect? Oh, you believe everything you read.
You believe every like side door that you see. Oh, hey,
if you see a bumper sticker, is that law? We rate CPR in our car. Who the fuck cares?
Yeah, the thing is he could have just told me that I was arrested and that I'm not going to see a judge that night. So I could just find you know, wrap my mind around that.
They're just riling you up. That's this entire time. That's what they've been doing.
All the cops that I told, like, hey, he just kept telling me I wasn't getting arrested. They're like, oh, yeah, he was telling you that so you remained calm. Maybe you should have been calm. And I'm like, I was calm. And also, this isn't an aggressive crime. And that guy goes, first of all, it is a crime. So if you want to pretend like you didn't commit, I was like, stop.
Yeah.
I said it wasn't an aggressive crime. I wasn't acting in an aggressive manner. And I was being calm the whole time. He could have just told me the truth. And they're like, yeah, I guess so. Anyway, so then I saw the lawyer, super nice woman. She's like, basically, you got a ticket for, you got a summons, which is like equivalent. It could have been like public peeing or open container or like smoking in public. And I'm like, I know I didn't do any of that. It was from 2002 that I didn't answer some sort of public garbage ticket that I need to be arrested for. And so I'm like, well, I got into things with the police. I've looked up my license. Like, nowhere does this happen. She's like, yeah, they're going to tell you that it's like a DNC or whatever it is. And you're going to get off and just you can say yes to that. And she explained it and it's fine. And then and in a half an hour, we're going to see the judge. I took that half an hour and I did yoga in my cell. I did.
That's who she thinks she is.
Well, I was by myself. And I was so anxious, and I was like, okay, in a half an hour, I'm going to see the judge. So I could either pace for a half an hour, which is a lot of what you do, or I could, I haven't done my yoga for the day. I'm just going to do a few little moves. And it was very helpful because I calmed down again, because the whole time you're just figuring out ways to calm down.
Yeah.
You know, because if you start acting like an animal, it's like, well, of course you're behind bars. Yeah, you're acting like an animal. So then there's like right outside of the court door, which is right outside of my cell, is where you line up to go see the judge. Mm-hmm. And you literally line up. You queue up against the wall. You're supposed to have your hands behind your back, but you're not cuffed. I'm standing next to a guy who's ahead of me, and we're against the wall. He's like giant compared to me. He's like about your size, Keith. And I'm like, I'm standing next to a, quote, criminal. He's standing next to a criminal too, right? We don't have handcuffs. No one's even looking our way, which means this is all bullshit. Like, you're not worried about this criminal. Do you know what I mean? Or me. And he's bigger than me. And, like, you know what I mean? So I turned to him, and I'm like, we're this close to getting out. I could ask people what they're in here for at this point. I turned to him, and I go, what did they get you for? However, I didn't phrase it anyway. It was very, it wasn't like, what are you in for? It was like, what crime? And so he goes, I had a suspended license. And I go, yeah, I jumped a turnstile. I go, you know what? This is really good because I really feel like the public is getting a little breath from us, and it's a little safer out there because we're in here. And he starts cracking up, and now we're just cracking each other up. But also with, like, you know, we're laughing, but there's like a very serious tone underneath it. Like, wow, it's 10 o'clock in the morning. If I had work that morning, which is Friday, I would have lost my job because I didn't get to a phone in time or whatever. Or my kids, they won't let people call to, like, let kids know. If Hennessy wasn't with me when I got arrested, he would have just been like, oh, no one's answering the phone. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, so all this thing. And by the time I saw the judge, I literally said, yes, sir, and yes, sir, and I left. And then it didn't dawn on me until later, like, yes, sir, what? Like,
three bags full.
Yeah, I'm just like, wait, what? I didn't even tell him how I got arrested or what happened or whatever, because I was like, wait, that's it? And they're like, yeah. And I'm like, so I leave? And they go, yeah. And I ran out of there because I'm just like, well, I don't know what else. And then later I was just like, I'm an idiot. I didn't speak up for myself. I didn't do anything because I'm so, like,
it's overwhelming.
There's fresh air, like, right out there. Just say yes, sir.
Right.
You know? And so I fucking left. And I asked Baby Butt while I was on the phone, which was a big mistake because obviously you're being recorded, idiot. So I'm just like, all I want is a fat blunt when I get home.
Wow.
And I'm just like,
and did you get one? Did you get a big blunt?
Well, in my second call, I was like, and by the way, I was kidding about that last call with the blunt. Like, that's what I said. And so I come home. I don't have the key because I gave him everything before I went home. Right. So I'm ringing the bell, and before, you know, he's staying up all night. I'm like, go to sleep. It's not like this is, I'm fine. Everyone's being really nice to me. Everyone's super nice. In fact, the girls, once I started saying how long we were there, they turned to each other at some point, and they're like, I'm so glad you guys are here because I definitely would have been crying. And they're like, oh, my God, somebody posted it on Facebook. This is so embarrassing. I'm like, oh, my God, these cute little, I know that their arrest could have been something serious, but they were just, I don't know, you know. So I get home. I'm ringing the doorbell. I'm banging on the window. I'm just like, I know he probably fell asleep. That's fine. I'm not going to get like upset about that. So I'm like, hey, hey, it's me. Where's my blunt? And he's like, oh, I smoked it and fell asleep.
Were joking. You said you were joking.
Right.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I'm going to take a shower. So I was like disgusted. And
you better be moved out when I come.
In the shower, I'm like, please don't, like, in my head, I'm like, please make him not ask me if I'm mad because I so want to tell him.
No.
You know what I mean? And I know that I'm livid for no reason. I haven't slept all night. Like, I just don't feel good, and I'm just going to react. And it's a blunt, and he's rolling it right now while I'm in the shower. It's not a big deal. But I'm like, oh my God, I just wanted a blunt when I come home from jail. I don't get it. Okay, you smoked my blunt and then you went to sleep. Okay, no, that's cool. That's cool.
Fucking Snoop Dogg over here.
Oh my God.
When I get out of jail, if my homies don't have a blunt ready for me,
what are you going to do when you get out of jail?
You know what I mean? I'm going to smoke some blunt, right? You know?
Right.
So,
thank you.
So I'm just livid for no reason, and I'm just like, I smoked blood, everything's fine. I'm just like, I'm sorry, I know.
Whatever, it makes sense. Yeah. I just want a cake when I come home. It's like I made the cake, but then like there was a cake, so I ate it.
Right.
And for you, it's just a delayed gratification thing,
right?
And your brain is haywire, and you're like, fuck you.
Right, I'm like, the one thing I ask for, and they only ask is for illegal drugs when I get home.
Wow.
And so here's the thing. It's like noon when I get home.
Yeah.
And that night I was having Siobhan over at my house. She does this play where she goes to people's houses and in the tub, like in your tub, she does a play for the people while they're sitting in the bathroom.
Oh, great.
Super cool.
It's in your house, to be clear.
It's in my place. I volunteered my place, but I just got home and it's noon and we were going to clean and go to the grocery store and like all this shit. Instead, we slept for 3 hours, cleaned until they got there. We did make fondue.
Oh, great.
Yes.
Wow, you squeezed fondue.
Yes, we did. I went to the store super quick because I was like, I'm going to be very upset with myself if there's no fondue. I was planning on fondue for this, and I want to be a good hostess.
Oh.
But I know I didn't tell them, Siobhan and her crew, like, that I got arrested.
She didn't ask? Like, I pictured, you know. I know, I was on a Chemda show. She'll always have a fascinating story. What's new? You guys are watching a show in a convict's apartment.
I didn't even want to say it because I didn't want them to like be concerned with me. But I have to admit that I wasn't as involved. I was, you know, I was gonna say hi to the people coming in. And
Siobhan's
like,
trying to say how hard it is to wash yourself when you have a broken wrist, and Hinda's like, "Fuck you."
I had sugar for breakfast.
You had sugar for breakfast.
I didn't take any of the sugar, but I just thought it was interesting that you're caging people up and giving them sugar. I just thought it was a little interesting.
Everything is deliberate. I mean, oh my God, I have shingles from listening to that story.
Thank you.
I'm so sorry that happened.
So what happens next?
Yeah.
I got to go to court tomorrow. That's for the 2002 thing, which they still didn't tell me what it was. I'm assuming I skated on the platform and just never addressed it. Yes, I'm such a criminal. And you know what? For those who gave me shit, Michael Khalili, my brother, you know, I knew.
For what? Because you did commit a crime, period?
No, here's the thing. I know he didn't really give me shit, but I knew not to pick up the call when he saw. I posted today. All right, I got locked up. Let's talk about it on the show. So he calls. He's like, what the fuck? And I'm like, of course. I pick up, it's my brother. And I'm like, blah, 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 and this thing happened, whatever. And he's like, that's fucked up, blah, blah, blah. And I go, and you know what? I don't think people should get arrested, even if it is a 2002 crime that you neglected. It's like, you know, I skated in public. Right. Do you know what I mean? I don't think people should get arrested. So he goes, so what do you think the punishment should be? And I'm like, I don't think I'm qualified for that. And if I don't have an answer for what the punishment actually needs to be that's appropriate to this goddamn crime, that doesn't mean that me getting arrested is appropriate for the crime.
Yep.
And he goes, well, you got to punish someone somehow. What's the thing? And I'm like, you know what? It's been like 24 hours. Maybe I'll find a way to punish myself in a little while. But, no, I don't think that you should fucking throw people in jail. And he agrees with it, but we should work out what way we should all be punished for fucking, you know, having an open container.
Or at least say, like, there should be no there should be a statute of limitations on skating on a platform.
Well,
of, like,
but then that gives everybody permission to, like, skate.
I guess so.
But here's the thing. Getting arrested is a serious thing.
Yeah.
You have to call out of work. Your cell phone gets stuck in there in the system for the next day as well. You can't call your babysitter. You can't call your job. They decided that I'm going to court tomorrow morning. 9:30. Tomorrow morning at 9:30, most people have to be at work, which means like, so people literally become homeless because you arrest them for this garbage charge. I know that I committed a crime, people. I know. But can we say that it's petty enough for me to never have to, me or anybody else, never have to get arrested? In fact, the numbers are the amount of arrests that they give people for jumping the turnstile would allow them to subsidize the cost of going through it anyway.
Wow.
So the amount of money that they're using to arrest us and to process us 2 hours for these goddamn cops just to work paperwork on me, the amount that they need, they could subsidize for everybody who can't afford it, who would jump the turnstile, who would like have a hard time paying. By the way, it's like almost $3 for one way. So if you have a job, it's $5.50 to get to work, and God forbid you want to go out afterwards because then it's another...
I owed an old credit card bill, and I said, you know what? Just put the stamp money to my bill and quit sending me these notices. Will you ever jump a turnstile again?
And I knew that you would ask me that, and I thought about that while I was in jail. I really did, and I'm like, will I do that? And here's my answer. I hope that I get the courage to jump it again because I don't believe in this system, and I hope that this didn't deter me from, like, I tell everybody else to jump it, and I tell them that the MTA sucks and this isn't the right system and that you shouldn't arrest me. I don't think I'm going to do it anytime soon because I am scared, but I hope, I really hope that I get the courage to do it again and to fight back some other way. And I know that this this quote, fight back, only fucking puts me behind bars or another ticket or whatever, but there's something about it where I don't want to be complacent because you gave me a bad night.
Yeah.
Did you learn that black people have it tough?
You think I didn't know? Like, what? Yeah, everything is evident that that black people have the hardest time. Everything is evident. Like, it's not, you don't have to go to jail to think that.
Right.
That's not the lesson I learned.
How is jumping the turnstile protesting?
Like, that were liars and assholes?
I was just trying to keep it. I'm not good with names, but I was, like, memorizing. I was like, okay, Officer Sin. Wow, your name is actually S-I-N. Okay, that's good. Got it. Okay, Officer McKenna, how am I going to remember that? That's a place on Maui, McKenna Highway, I believe. McKenna, Officer McKenna.
Wow.
Officer Rodriguez, well, you're talking on your phone for, like, fucking 2 hours. Your badge is facing me for 5 years, so I remembered your goddamn name. And I know what you were playing. I know that you weren't fucking processing anything. Because I can tell that you were playing a game, and I can tell when you were scrolling through Instagram, Officer Rodriguez, because I know that that's not how you fill paperwork. You know, like how people play a game where they're just like, hit this corner, then hit that corner.
Yeah,
it's like, you know, and I'm just, and when he looks at me, I try not to look away because I'm like, no.
Right.
I'm
watching
at you.
Yeah.
I'm looking at you playing your fucking game.
And then it goes, donut award.
Donut award.
Hey, Michael, how you doing?
Oh, man. I'm ready to go. I'm all riled up. So I got a couple of notes here.
Okay.
But first time that you do make a good point in that prison should be a last resort.
Yeah, prison is very serious. I know I didn't go to prison, but even getting arrested is very
serious. Or jail. Whatever. Yeah, arresting somebody should be a last resort. It should be a resort because you can't have people jumping the turnstiles all the time.
Oh, no?
It has to be punishment for
Thanks
them.
For telling me.
No, well, you're saying you think jumping the turnstile should be like a form of protest. How is jumping the turnstile a form of protest?
How is anything a form of protest?
What does that mean?
How is walking the streets with signs a form of protest? How is jumping the turnstile? Me jumping the turnstile and then speaking on my show of 10,000 listeners is a protest. Me going through the system because I tell everybody else to do it is a form of protest. Me telling you that I don't agree with the system and then going against the system is a form of protest.
What is the system that you're trying to fight against? The fact that you should pay for a service that you're using?
Yeah.
You shouldn't pay for a service that you need to use.
Not necessarily, because I pay with my taxes also, and I don't pay to get arrested. And I'm paying for you to arrest me. Can I pay for that? Is that the system that I can pay for?
I don't think that the money you're paying in terms of the fine pays for the cops that are arresting you. It's not like the
cops
are profiting.
What does it pay for? Schooling? Because it doesn't seem to pay for my schooling or for anybody else's
schooling. No, what I'm saying is you seem to think as if the city is profiting off arresting you. But like
you
said, there are four cops taking you in, right? How much is your fine? How much do you think your fine is going to be for jumping the turnstiles? Like $100 first time offender or something like that? That is nowhere near what it costs to process and arrest you. Or to even just give you the ticket.
You're saying
the
same point I am.
They don't arrest you. They weren't going to arrest you on jumping the turnstile, which is the right thing to do. They shouldn't arrest you on that. Though if you don't pay the ticket and if you don't show up to court and you're a habitual turnstile jumper, I think arrest is a resort.
Really? You think that by me being behind bars, it's a safer place? You think arresting is good? First of all, turn up my fucking mic for a second. Just so you know, when you're talking about this, you are talking about me. You can't just fucking isolate my incident, okay? And just because I keep talking about jumping the turnstile, that doesn't mean they caught me every fucking time that they're going to take me to jail and you're talking about me like I'm a criminal. It is not safer when I'm behind bars, and it's not safer for me to pay this fucking fine. And if you're talking about it's $100 for my arrest, and it's four cops that are taking their time that I'm paying for as well. So I'm paying for the ticket, and I'm paying for the cops' time, and I'm paying for the guy who gives me water in jail, and I'm paying for the EMS. So don't tell me that they don't have the budget to subsidize these fucking rides.
They don't have the budget, because what you're thinking about in terms of all the arrests are nowhere near what it costs.
They're arresting
to make the rides free.
I'm talking about just the arrests of jumping the turnstile. Just that arrest.
Need to separate the two, because you didn't get arrested for jumping the turnstile. You would have gotten a ticket. You got arrested for an old issue that when
same
you
thing.
Didn't see the
same thing. I don't think I should get arrested for that either.
Thing.
But in my mind, these two qualify as me not getting arrested. This is not
failure to show is something that the reason you get a ticket and you don't get dragged in is because you promised to show up in front of a court or pay your fine. So you can either fight the fee, you can either take care of it, pay it, or go to court or write in a letter or an affidavit to say why you should be found not guilty.
And when that doesn't happen, what if I sent the payment in and they didn't get it, and 15 years later I get caught doing this, where I paid my fare and my husband goes behind me and I go to jail? What
I thought we're not talking about weird hypotheticals. We're talking about the situation in front of us.
Come the fuck on. You can't really understand any of this.
But you're making these micro hypotheticals of a bureaucratic foul-up comparing to what happened.
What do you think the system should do?
I think that the system should not arrest you for jumping the turnstile, which it didn't.
Should they arrest me for the summons I didn't pay 15 years ago?
I think that if you have a failure to show, then you need to be brought in front of a judge. Yes,
Should I be arrested for failing to pay a summons? Something like an open container or skating on the platform. Should I be arrested for not paying that?
I think eventually
other punishment. There's not, you know, maybe garnishing wages, which I also think is very extreme. There's not maybe like, so I, and the fact that I can't.
Every recourse, you're not comfortable with. You're not comfortable with any recourse of collecting this debt.
You didn't name all the resources. You literally named me being arrested or not. I'm naming other resources.
No, that's what I'm saying. You're going through a list of resources that you're not comfortable with.
And I'm not aware. I'm not aware of all of their recourses. I'm not aware of what you can do to punish a criminal like me. Okay? But I understand that I'm not a criminal who needs to be treated this way, because I'm not. No one's safer. And that's the whole thing, is people getting put behind bars is to make life safer for you and me.
Agreed.
Me
that
being behind a bar
extreme...
for skating on a platform, even if I didn't respond to it, does not warrant an arrest, whether I committed some other bullshit crime or not.
My issues is that the arrest was sort of processed under false pretenses.
And not sort of.
Yeah.
Of course it was. And it was...
You can spend time arguing with me 5 minutes after this happened, just like you called in what are protests doing? Why does Black Lives Matter being called Black Lives Matter? Just like the garbage that spews out 5 seconds after people have been beat or put behind bars, that this is the stance that you decide to take, that it's very important, is just weird to me. What are you
but
didn't
I
weren't
don't
you the
you
one who
been
said
arrested.
let's get mad at the people who have the power, not mad at the people who fucking skate on a platform? I shouldn't be arrested.
I'm agreeing with
Start
you. You're
there.
Upset at things that I'm agreeing with you on. I don't think you should have been arrested for jumping the turnstile. I don't think you should have been arrested for scanning on the platform. I think there should have been other recourses to collect before arrest, but I do think eventually down the line, arrest is a recourse. I don't think they should have arrested you when you jumped the turnstile. I think there should have been many steps in between having a warrant out for your arrest. But eventually, I think that you have to see a judge. I think eventually, if you're deflecting payments, I was trying to go down that route, but then you said, let's talk about the issue that we have in front of us. So then I'm trying to stay with the caveat that no, you shouldn't have been arrested for this. You're not, like you're saying, you're not a threat to society. But what they do need to do is collect on these fines. Otherwise, there's no point in fining people. What's the point in paying if there's no way of collecting?
Let me tell you, I'm not saying that they shouldn't be collected from me. That's a different story, and I'm not about that story either. But let's start with, yes, of course I should pay, but it shouldn't end up with me being in jail. I don't know how, and I think that's okay right now. I think it's okay for me not to know because I didn't take that job. Just like the cops don't know how to tell a fucking decent joke, I shouldn't have to figure out what a good punishment is for people like me.
I don't understand. Well, why not? That's weird. If you're the one involved in this, what do you think a fair way to collect that money?
I don't
money
know. Give me
spend?
A minute.
I mean, God, but, it's not like credit card companies will like fucking put handcuffs on you if you don't pay your bills. It's like, I mean, they'll come and like,
which is wrong. Debtor's
stuff.
Prison is wrong, right? That's wrong, and they're
so
not allowed to
so
do
why
that.
Why do you but, argue these other points? What? Why do you want like do something else?
Because your attitude is you should never have any consequences
yeah,
for
that's
jumping
my
the
attitude.
Turnstile. You
take
want to
that
jump
back. Take
you,
that back.
You want to keep jumping
no,
the turnstile.
No, that's not what I said. Take
you,
that back. No, what? I didn't say that I shouldn't have any consequences. I'm saying that the consequences are bullshit. Libby's writing in, the past few years, the MTA had a surplus of between $400 million and $2 billion. And that Bowen has to leave in 10 minutes.
No. No, I'm here.
No, I
can't.
I'm just fighting with my brother. No big deal. All right, Michael, this was a great call.
So let me just say one last sentence. Of course, victimless crimes and fines in debtor's prison are ridiculous ways, ridiculous reasons to put people in jail. And I agree wholeheartedly on that. Though eventually you have to collect on some debts. Debt collection issues, debt collection payments, garnishing
well,
wages.
Well, they did it, Michael.
Some way.
They did it.
Prison should be a last resort, and I agree with you on that. Prison should be a last resort. I think I agree with you on that. Prison should be a last resort.
All right. We did it. Look at that.
Yeah, well, now the cops can pay for more stuff because I'm going to pay my big fat fucking debt.
Well, they're not paying for anything.
Shut
it
up.
Costs money to process you.
Sorry.
It's not profitable for the
sorry,
police.
Mom said not to do that.
The money you're paying, the fine you're going to have to pay, is not going to pay for all the people that are taking
yeah,
you in the court.
No, that's what
that.
I'm talking about. Just my fine paying everybody's. Yes, that's. I'm some asshole who's going, I pay your wages. Come on. I know that a great argument isn't the quote, come on, but come on.
But you're making these arguments. You're saying that the police are they're making money off you rather than putting you in jail for jumping the turnstile. They should take that money and pay for everybody's turnstile.
Yep. That mass adds
the budget for the MTA is bigger than the budget for the police.
That's not what I'm talking about, and that's a whole bunch of math that we can do later. Thank you.
You earlier said that they could subsidize this with the fee.
I'm an idiot.
I mean, that's not fair either. That's not fair to say that
hey,
way either.
We're going
I mean, you're
in
making
circles.
Statements,
it's not
but
fair to hijack my show.
I mean, I guess, yeah, it's your show, but you're making statements that the underlying information under them is just, it's just not right. It's just incorrect.
I don't know. I'm not.
Can we agree on this?
Remember that time you took
No, no, because I already agreed on shit that I signed at that later I found out I was arrested. No.
I'm never agreeing
no.
to anything.
We can't just agree on shit that I just to make things go away, apparently. No, that's not a good idea. We learned that. That is the real lesson. No.
So no common ground.
I don't know. What's the difference?
The difference is common ground, and it's easier to be clear on what we don't agree, because I think there's some grayness into what we don't agree. You were saying things that I don't think I meant to say, and I think I was saying things that you didn't mean to say. Well, coming up with common ground, we could clarify what we
I don't think it's going to happen right now, which is why it's just not going to happen. So I think that keysinthegrill.com/forums, I think those guys are going to have a lot to say about it, and I'll definitely read every word, and definitely a lot of people won't be on my side, but they'll be able to be, you know, more accurate statistics there that I can review and do the math on and give you a better answer of what pieces of shit like me should be treated like.
But nobody's calling you a piece of shit, though. Like, I didn't say those words about you.
No, take that joke seriously.
All right, Michael.
You're not a lowlife. I agree. You don't belong in jail.
You're a good
person. I just don't agree with these protests where it's like, fuck the man, I'm jumping the turnstile.
You don't agree
when you're accomplishing nothing. Those are the things that I think we disagree on.
I'm going to take this call, Mike. I'm going to let you go. Thanks, buddy.
Thanks, Michael.
Bye, Michael.
Hey, how's it going? You're on Keith and the Girl.
Hey, guys. It's Rosa.
Rosa, what's doing?
Hey, what's up?
I wanted to agree with one piece of something Chemda is saying, which is just that the New York system for like arresting and issuing summonses and all that shit is bullshit, and they do waste money. And my example is that I trespassed in Prospect Park after sundown once, and I had to take a day off of work to appear in court in New York City to have a judge tell me, you're not allowed to do that. Do you understand? And bang a gavel. I paid zero fine. They could have just asked me for $20. I'd have paid a ticket and happily not taken a whole day off work, paid for a bus, come down to the city, all this shit. And they would have made $20 and they wouldn't have had to pay all those people to process my shit and have a judge sit there and bang his gavel. So I think there are better ways to do this shit. And New York has to figure this stuff out because I don't have
figure it out, you fucking criminal. What are you doing at a park after the sunset? That's disgusting. What are you, a whore? You're obviously doing drugs.
I was technically smoking weed and drinking beer, but not when the cops showed up.
Oh, no.
With children. Anyways.
No, of course you're smoking weed. What are you doing in a park? But come on.
All right, Rosa, take care.
Yeah. Anyhow, I'm sorry you got arrested.
Thank you. That's what we're going to call the show. I'm sorry you got arrested. That's all I want.
All right, y'all take care.
All right, later. Bye. Bowen, final thoughts?
Oh, my God. Okay, here's the thing. I feel like the putative, and this, I don't know if this satisfies your brother's, what he's arguing for, against, or whatever, but I feel like the putative measure behind, a neglected summons should not be... That doesn't balance out the ledger of hiring all these people to process this, the arrest, the processing, whatever. I don't know.
You heard it here first.
I think being lied to by what, if you ask me, should be considered one of the most powerful jobs in the world. I think that's criminal.
Yeah. Oh wow. Lying to someone is criminal.
I said all that shit, and Keith says that, and it's, oh wow.
No, I mean,
you can't have a lying cop like that unless you're undercover, you know?
Right.
Plainclothes. But if you have something like this, and you're lying about being arrested, this is criminal. It's when I read a news story, and a cop was drunk driving, and I'm like, and that should be a bigger punishment than a regular person.
Right. A lawyer would be disbarred, for example.
Right.
Yeah. If he got caught driving under the influence, mm-hmm. it wouldn't even be a one-time thing. He would be disbarred because you are part of the law system. You're part of the system where you have to uphold it better than other people.
Officer Sin may either have his arms cut off or his penis. His choice.
And Officer Rodriguez will never be able to download an iPhone game.
He never finished that level, son of a bitch.
Good news is these phones now, they trick you. These games, and you have to pay for in-app purchases. And so let's like to think that he's one of these morons.
And Chemda is paying for these subscriptions, and it's a farce.
Bowen Yang, you want to go to the Twitter account at Bowen Yang, BOWENYANG.
Mm-hmm.
You can also go to BowenYangComedy.com and see everything that's going on. He is co-hosting Showgasm at Ars Nova April 6th. With the great drag performer Ruby Roo.
Ooh.
He has a podcast as well, Las Cacheristas.
Ooh.
He's having a live show also at Littlefield with 50 comedians. Good luck getting that together.
Yeah.
March 21st at 8 p.m.
Terrible.
Bowen, really nice meeting you.
Thanks,
guys.
A lot, man.
That was so cool. Thank you.